Hi, my name is Nithya Narasimhan. I'm a senior developer advocate on the Microsoft Developer Relations team, and I'm here to talk to you about JavaScript functions. We're going to cover 5 things you need to know when you talk about JavaScript functions. Let's get started. First, what are functions? Functions are basic blocks of code that are executing a series of statements that you tend to use over and over again in your program. By abstracting these into a reusable function, you end up getting 2 benefits. We're going to talk about that in a second, but there are a couple of examples of functions that you see right here. In the first case, you have a function that just prints a very common message. In the second case, you have a function that actually computes a result given 2 inputs. Keep these examples in mind. Why are functions useful? Because when you have code like this that you use again and again and again, by abstracting them into a function that is reusable, you get 2 benefits. First, you get readability and conciseness. Think about a task that takes 10 lines of code that you use 5 times in your program. That's 50 lines of code right there. By abstracting it into a function, you can potentially reduce it to the 10 lines of code for the execution of the task and 5 invocation statements, from 50 to 15. The second, which is actually the more appealing use case for me, is maintainability. In this example, you can see that I wanted to change how I wanted to do something with the compute price function. If I had kept to my original intent of having that code replicated 5 times in my program, I would have to go back and make this change at every single location. By abstracting it into a function, I only have to make the change in one place. That makes the code maintainable by anyone who has to come and take care of it even after I've gone. So let's move on to the second thing you need to know. What does a function syntax look like? How do you define one? This is an example of a function in JavaScript. I've highlighted it in different colors so we can quickly talk about the different components of a function definition. The function keyword in blue is what identifies that code as defining a function in JavaScript. The most important thing you want to recognize here before we look at the other components is the curly braces that are highlighted in yellow that kind of scope out the statements that form the execution part of the function. Next, pay attention to the fact that this function has a name in green, and the name is what you use to actually execute or invoke the function. This is just the definition. Third, we have parameters here shown in red. Think of parameters as placeholders for the input data that you need to pass to your function. Finally, we have a return statement. A return statement provides 2 kinds of value to you. We're going to talk about this in just a minute, but think of return statements as a way for you to ship data out or provide a result or output from the execution of the function. All right, so thing number 3. What we looked at there was the definition of a function. But the definition is not the same as invoking it. Think of the definition as a blueprint that tells you what the function does. The invocation is where you actually call it so it does it. So the big difference, when you define a function, you've got the little curly braces, there's no semicolon, you're really kind of giving a blueprint for the statements in the function. To actually execute it, you would invoke the name of the function with the curly braces, with the standard braces. Pass in any arguments if that original definition had any parameters. And that's it. So here, the print hello to invoke it, you literally say print hello, open brackets, the actual instance of a name you want to provide, close brackets, and you get back the result, hello world. All right, item number 3. We talked about the syntax, we talked about invocation. Now let's talk about the different pieces. We talked about a function name. Function names in JavaScript are really about user-friendly, readable ways that allow you to immediately, at a glance, know what the function does, wherever you're calling it from. It's like variable names in terms of conventions. You can use any alphabet or numerical character, dollar signs and underscores, but no other special characters. Go try it out. We'll have a little demo video that shows you different examples, but go try it out and you'll see that if you were to use any special characters, you'll have errors in your editor. One interesting thing is functions are themselves objects. So you can use the function .name property to get back a string version of what the function name is, if for any reason you didn't know what it was. Finally, there's a special case known as anonymous functions that don't have a standard name. We're not going to cover that here. That will be covered in a different module, but feel free to go look it up online and learn a little bit about what anonymous functions are. All right, on to item number 4. We're really roaring through this, aren't we? Remember how I told you functions have a name? They can take parameters as placeholders for inputs, and they can return a result. Let's talk a little bit about the parameter side. Parameters are placeholders for input values. You can think of them as variable names that are used in the code, the definition of the function, as placeholders for the execution. When you actually invoke the function, you will pass arguments, actual values, that will replace every location of the parameter when you execute the function itself. Parameters are optional. You can have functions with no parameters whatsoever. For example, a print thanks function that just puts a nice friendly message. Anyone who calls it gets the exact same result. If you do pass parameters though, just know this. When you pass arguments to it during invocation, the JavaScript runtime does not actually check to see if the number of arguments you provided or the type of arguments that you provided match those of the parameters. What that means is that if you were to provide fewer values than were required, it's not going to tell you. It's just going to fill in undefined for every parameter that you have not allocated an argument or value to. So in this example, you can see in the compute price function, when I invoke it, it actually takes two parameters, but I only passed in one argument. And as you can see from the result, the second argument was seen as undefined, and therefore I might end up with a slightly unexpected result. So one takeaway for you is if you are using functions that have complex execution statements, make sure you validate your data or you validate your arguments as part of the function definition. And we're down to the last point, and this is the return statement. So one thing you need to know about functions is those curly braces, they enclose the execution statements of the function. If you did not have a return statement, return statements are absolutely optional, your function will exit by default when you get to the final curly brace. At that point, it returns back to whoever called it. However, I usually recommend that you do have a return statement. Return statements have two really useful value propositions. First, they give you a very clear idea of where your function is going to exit. This is particularly useful if you have conditional statements. You know, if within your function, you're saying, based on this input, I want to do this, this, and this, or based on that input, I want to do that, that, and the other. In this case, you want to have return statements so that when you finish executing the correct path, you exit the function without going and doing things you shouldn't have done. The other useful value proposition for return is it allows you to provide an output result that gets returned back to the caller. So this is a great way for you to provide results based on the computations or execution of tasks that you did. In this particular example for compute price, we're using the return statement to return the value, the computed price, based on the cost of the item and the discount that has been provided. Again, if you didn't have a return statement, by default, the value returned is undefined. So you'll see in the example there that when I call compute price with the right values, I get a proper result. But when I call print hello, which doesn't have any parameters and has no return statement, I simply get back undefined. Well, that was 5 things you hopefully learned about JavaScript functions today. What functions are, why they matter, your naming conventions and tips for naming them, what function parameters do for you, and last but not least, why you need return statements. See you on the next module.